Hello there, my name is Mr. Smart Donkey. Welcome to another Let's Play on Total War Shogun 2, another legendary Let's Play, of course. So, today we're going to be playing, not yet, Rise or Fall the Samurai. We're going to be playing as the Hojo. Well, I say today, I obviously mean today and the next couple of weeks. So we're playing as the Hojo. I've actually had a few people, I believe, already ask me to play as the Hojo in the past. And of course I will, I will do all the clans eventually. Well, I mean, it's only the Hojo, the Mori, the Tokugawa and the Yasuji that are left now, and then we've finished all the clans except for, of course, all the Rise of the Samurai and Fall of the Samurai campaigns, but that'll be later. So the Hojo are the master builders. They have castles that are cheaper to build and repair. They can recruit superior siege units, and they have reduced recruitment costs and upkeep for siege units. So they're an interesting clan because they use a lot of units that I never use normally, and normally wouldn't really use either, even if I had easy access to them. Like the firebomb throwers. Why use firebomb throwers if you can have Kisho Ninja, for example? And then they have the fire mangonels, like improved fire mangonels, because of course everyone can access those. We even have the siege, or the like the cannon. I can't remember the name of it exactly, but that's not necessarily a Hojo gun either, but that's one that I might use as well. But I believe I have to be Christian to be able to use that one. And then there's the fire rockets, and there's another one of those. There's several really awesome siege units. One of them is actually a DLC unit, but still. So I will probably get to use all of those, which is pretty cool because I wouldn't really use them normally. But I might use those instead of like archers or something like that. There's a good chance I will go Christian. I'm not entirely sure yet, just because it gives me more access to, like I said, the cannons and such as well. And I feel like the Hojo is sort of a clan to go, since I use bombs and shit as well, like firepower, they may as well use guns. Well, I mean, they can use guns already, even if they're not Christian, but still. Anyway, we'll figure it out along the way. So for now, I think, what the hell, I was going to do an outro there. For now, we're going to go into the cutscene, I was going to say. So, here we go.
This is Sengoku Jidai, the age of the country at war. For 200 years, the Ashikaga shoguns have ruled from Kyoto. Great splendor and power were theirs. Now the overmighty clans no longer obey. The time has come for a new warlord to become shogun. But who will be victorious? Hojo lands have always provided for our people. Our enemies are many and envious. They threatened our borders and look for any weakness. Our castles are strong, the envy of Japan. We are rightly admired as master builders. Strong walls, strong souls. Our siege engines are equally mighty. Nothing stands before them. Shamonten, the war god, has woken. Now is the time to defeat our enemies. All will bow to the Hojo clan. We wait no longer. Destiny calls! We are the Hojo. For many years, we have vied for control of Kanto, bringing us into conflict with a number of rival clans. Having captured territory from the Imagawa, we have brokered an uneasy truce in order to service our more pressing concerns. The Ogigayats and the Amanouchi clans have united for fear of our mighty ambition. Musashi is therefore a priority. Capture of this province will rid us of the Ogigayatsu and gain us a foothold at the heart of Kanto. While we may have eased the tensions with Imagawa, it will only be a matter of time before their lethal ambition threatens our plans once again. Capture of Suruga will weaken their potential greatly, but we must be wary of the Takeda. Bound by blood and honor, the Takeda will not look kindly on any act of aggression against their allies, and they are a formidable force. Seizure of Kai, their home province, could provide an answer, but facing the combined might of two great clans may best be left until our own has grown in stature. However, with power and influence will surely come the ire of Kyoto, and should the Shogun feel threatened, he will rally his subjects against us. In that event, we must be prepared to fend off all who would attack us, no matter from where that threat emerges. If the Shogun wishes to halt our expansion, let him come here and reckon with us himself.
Alright, so there's our first mission. Defeat an army belonging to the following clan, the Ogigayatsu. And we get Dreaded Force, which instills fear in enemy units for 4 turns. If our daimyo is to become Shogun, military ruler of all of Japan. Right, so the Hojo, they have an interesting starting position because they start with Izu, which has a gold mine, which is always great for money. Or barren soil, though, which is terrible. And they also start with Sagami, which is really good because they get the blacksmith right away, which will turn into most likely an armorer. I think this is going to be a relatively defensive force, or our armies will be defensive since we will have siege engines and such. Which means we're not made for rushing towards the opponent. We're just going to sit back, let our siege engines do most of the work, and then we go in and deliver the final blow. But I should probably... I've not actually thought about, at all thought about what our armies are going to be looking like in the end. I'm not a massive fan of the siege engines because they also get rid of your movements range, basically. They reduce it by a pretty decent amount, which is kind of a problematic thing that I'm not a big fan of, so I don't usually use them, but because we are playing the Hojo, we will. But anyway, yeah, so our plan for the future, I'm not entirely sure yet exactly. Our first plan will be to take Musashi, but after that I'm not entirely sure where I want to go, especially since the Kai and the Imagawa are allied to each other, so if I attack one, I'll have to attack the other as well, unless I can get them to attack me. And it's kind of a... these two provinces, at least, are an annoying combo to have if you don't have Suruga as well, because it doesn't provide a choke point. They could go to Sugami, they could go to Izu, and I can only set up my army on one of the places if I were to have to defend. Suruga, on the other hand, is also annoying because if I am at war with Kai, or even if I'm not at war with them, still, I leave myself open for them to attack either Suruga or Sugami or Izu or even Musashi. Once I take both Suruga and Kai, I'm actually going to have to leave some kind of force in both towns unless I move up from Kai and actually conquer more that way. But the most reasonable thing to do would be to go east and just take all the bigger lands up here, which will make us quite a bit of money as well. Hitachi is one of the priorities because of the craftworks, which will give us the Fletchers and just higher accuracy for any ranged unit, which we will have plenty of. Probably not going to have any cavalry in these armies, so I'm guessing probably a general or two, 10 infantry units, and 6 or 8, so, well, 10 or 12 infantry units and 6 or 8 ranged units. Maybe a few archers, maybe a few siege weapons, maybe a firebomb thrower or two, which I thought we started with one of them, but we don't, which is... I don't know. I kind of feel like instead of giving you the Yari Samurai, they should have given you the Hojo Firebomb Thrower instead or something, since that's our signature unit, I suppose. But anyway, so that's the plan, is to go east for now, and then we'll see once we've taken all of that. So let's get going. First of all, our daimyo is a 30-year-old. That's pretty good. Commissioner for Warfare First General is 31 years old. Also pretty good. Our daimyo has plus one morale for all units under this man's command. He enables night battles, which is awesome. Minus 5% to the character's chance of being assassinated. So that's pretty strong. It's not a bad general at all. And then we have a 7-year-old son, a 6-year-old son, and a 4-year-old son. That's not bad. They will probably all see battle in the end. So first of all, let's see if we can get some trade going with the Imagawa. Apparently not.
A friend is always welcome, especially in these times of trouble. Come, let us talk.
Another option is definitely to make them our ally. The thing is, though, I really want to actually have Suruga because they have the school, and if I can get my hands on that early, I'll be able to make really high-level Metsukes right away, which will be extremely strong, especially since we already have a gold mine, so we want to make as much money as possible from that right away. So that's definitely something I want to get my hands on. They don't actually want to trade with me, which is too bad. And I can probably sell some military access to them, but I also risk them attacking me, so I'd rather not. I am already trading with the Takeda, so there's not a whole lot of diplomacy to be done, except for selling military access, but I don't really want to go down that route anymore, if I can avoid it. So, first of all, we have a Siege Engineer's Workshop here. We have an open slot here, which will definitely be a market, so let's get our Mastered Yards going right away. I think I'm going to go for Todofuken first, just so we can get the market going. I do want to get Bushido really early on as well, actually. I might honestly... I am going to use these units, but I might get rid of the Siege Engineer's Workshop here and then rebuild it once we get to Itachi, since I'll be making the units there anyway. So I'm going to get rid of this. I'm actually going to go for a Sword School, or at least Bushido first, and then we're going to go for Todofuken. Because then if we can get the Sword School going, we'll be able to like make just maybe one or two Katana Samurai, which will be extremely strong for this army. Which means I do want to upgrade this as soon as possible, but it's not a massive priority. But if we don't have a whole lot of us to do, then it'll be fine. Because I'm not going to upgrade any of the farms here for now, at least, because it's all barren soil, which is just the only reason I would do it is for the extra food. I could get a harbor and upgrade it to a trading port for trade, but that would be the only reason, because there's no trade nodes anywhere nearby. So that's also not super high on the priority list. So I think I will actually go for an armor right away. It's not a bad idea, and we'll make some men here. Sounds like an alright plan. I could obviously make them here instead, but the move over there would take an extra turn anyway, so there's really not any point. Right, so let's get our first battle going, I suppose. Alright, so you're fighting a Yari Cav, a Yari Samurai, 2 Yara Shigaru, and 1 Boa Shigaru. Got a pretty similar army, except of course we have 2 generals instead of the 1 Yari Cav. Could do a night attack, but there's really no point. But it's useful to have the ability to do so. That's for sure. So our first battle against the Ogigiyatsu, if we come out of this relatively unscathed, we'll be able to take on their town right away, because I wouldn't assume that they have a lot of units there, since they have like, what, 6 units right here. however many it was. So it'd be kind of silly if they had another 6 units or whatever sitting in their town as well. I think I've had this talk before, or I've talked about this before, where if I were to choose between the army that I currently control or the army that the enemy controls, I probably would have gone for the one with the enemy, because of the Yari Cav. They can just completely slaughter the 2 generals I have. Alright, I will just take drawing, that's fine. This is the first 1 or 2 general speeches, and then we'll leave that for someone else's let's play. Or for when you play it yourself.
カタナは抜いた。敵方に一人でも生き残りがいる限り、この刀、鞘には収め。全ては家のためじゃ。我が敵は、奴らの領主と一門に忠誠を誓う勇敢な侍どもだ。あの者どもを滅ぼすとなると心が痛むが、 これも運命のなせる技。仕方なかろう。鬼門から戦場に入ってしまったが、なぜか敵がそれを見ておじけづいとるようじゃ。我が陣営に鬼神が取り付いたとでも思い込んどるのかもの。これだけは約束する。戦が終わったら忙しくなる。跳ねた敵の首を集めて数えんとならんからな。
I do actually really like the color combination of the Hojo. They're blue and then the red in there as well. Actually, it looks fairly good. Somewhat surprisingly, normally I don't like red and blue together, but I don't know. I just love their outfits. Anyway, so they do have a nice little hill up here that they probably will be using, but it's not too bad. We have forest cover while we go in there, and also it's not too steep either. I will assume that they take it though, so I will just set up right here. Keep my Yari Samurai on. Keep him on this side. And two generals. Which we have to really be wary of, that we don't lose them to the Yari Cav on the enemy side. Alright. Let's get moving up. Let's see. Alright, so yeah, they are at the back of the hill there. I can see their Boyashigaro. I can see everything actually. Looks like they might be... No, I think they are coming just straight up the hill. Yeah, I thought for a second they were running that way. It looks like they're Yari Cavs running up front, but that's normal. He's just going to take the hill. I don't think I really want to go into an archer battle. Because they have the hill and the forest, and we probably wouldn't even have the forest. So... they would just completely obliterate me when we go, if we were to go archer battle. Let's run up our units a little bit further though. Oh. Gonna get this guy over here. It looks like he has a Yari Cav on the side as well, and then at least we'll be able to flank with it. And we might even be able to just attack their Yari Cav with it. Let's keep these men moving up as well. Looks like his archers are nearly in range already. So I think I'm gonna run these men up here. Oh. Get my archers to start firing at them as well. Run these guys up here. I will get myself killed quite a bit here. There's not much we can do about it. And I should keep my generals actually close to my Yaris in case something happens and he runs his men around. Got these guys coming as well. We of course have Yari Wall. We will notice their men soon, hopefully. We have not lost too many yet, yeah, there they are. Okay. They look like they're in Yari Wall too. They had a Yari Samurai there, yeah. There he is. Okay. We're not going to actually engage with this unit. I just want to engage into their bow unit here. But we will just get up this hill and wait for this unit to arrive before I engage into their actual Yaris, because there's no reason to get my men killed here. Also get my archers to start firing at these men. Get them inspired. Start going on to that Yari Cav unit. If we take them out of the equation, it'll be easy. I'm actually gonna go around a little bit this way before we initiate with that unit accidentally. Well, it looks like he's charging us, so... and he managed to get a actual charge off, whereas we did not really. Okay, and they're coming to engage with us, but we're in Yari Wall, so that's fine. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can actually run these men around this way. Our archer units firing a single shot every once in a while. They don't really have any good opportunities to fire. I need to make sure he doesn't go for my generals there. That's the only concern I have, really. Otherwise, I'll be able to charge these men fairly well in the rear. Looks like these men are already shattering. Somewhat surprised since they are a Yari Samurai unit. They haven't quite shattered yet, but they're not looking too well. Of course, these are men without a general, but still... Yeah, let's have this guy's charging there. Let's have him charging there. This unit might not break, but this one looks like it will.
Our general is in grave danger, my lord!
Oh, I'm sure he is. Alright, there we go. He managed to shatter them. So let's get in there. That's a Yari Cav. It's going to be a charge on a Yari Cav. Not really recommended, but it might just break this unit. Still wavering. There we go.
A glory glorious victory will soon be yours.
Not too bad. Not too great. Lost a little too many of my Yariashigaru. More than I wanted, anyway. But, nothing too bad. I would have preferred losing more of my Yari Samurai, since that's the unit I'll probably get rid of in the end anyway. Since it's too expensive for what it is right now. I'm actually going to send one of the generals after that unit. You guys can just halt. Archers got a total of 4 kills. Well done, archers. I love you. Yeah, Boashigaru are shit. They're just so bad. I hate them so much. They can all die. there's so many shit units in the beginning of the game. Like, the only... It's just annoying how the Yariashigaru is, like, superior to any other unit in the game. Actually, I should use these guys. Surely there's something else to kill still. But yeah, the Yariashigaru is, like, superior to any other unit in the game. And the Yari Samurai that you get... Sorry, what did I say? Yariashigaru is superior to any other unit in the game. And the Yari Samurai that you get is completely worthless, basically. And the Boashigaru is even more worthless, but they're cheaper, so they're not as worthless. But just because of Yari Wall, the Yariashigaru is just... It's just insane. Anyway, let's triple speed the rest of this here. Hopefully we can kill more of the unit off. That'd be great. Alright, close victory. Once again, I don't really agree with game, but hey. Whatever you say. Alright, so this will probably allow us to just finish them off with an auto-resolve, and I don't think I'm going to attack their town this turn. I'm not entirely sure what turn, or what season this was, though. Because it wasn't winter, so we should be fine to just attack next turn. The question I have is, can my reinforcement unit that I'm currently building, can he reach their town in one turn, or not? Anyway, we've got Dreaded Force. I am going to go in and finish them off. Hopefully I'll be able to reach back in my own time. Probably will. Really? Bar? Really? Alright, and there's a level up. What can we see? Okay, we can see they've got another 4 units. And we can also see that we can't reach. Unless maybe I do this, but probably still not. No, not quite. Meh. Yeah, I said we're not going to have any charge. So yeah, we'll go for attacking on land. So yeah, we can't reach right now. We might be able to reach with the, like, if we attack with the general, but there's really no reason to do so. So let's just go back to our own province, and we'll attack next turn. And maybe this guy will be able to reach there as well. And maybe he will come out and attack me, and I'll be fine too. Right, so I think that's going to be this first turn done. We've got everything queued up. Our general level up was already. That's great. We are currently only trading with the Takeda for a total of 79 Koku. Once again, we can't trade with the Imagawa. I don't suppose anything changed. Why would it? Nothing happened yet. Could get an alliance with them, which is, like I said, somewhat good, but I actually really want to get this province, so... Nope. Not yet, anyway. Maybe if something changes for whatever reason, I might change my mind. Kai's left open because the Takeda always move up to North Shinano. Alright, so we want to get Strategy of Attack, which will give us the Hojo Fire Projecting Mongols. Not a very difficult one to get. I actually should have a look at this, so I have no idea which building gives me what. I assume it's the this thing that brings me to... Yeah, the Fire Projecting Mongols means we have to get the Powder Maker, which requires Attack by Fire. Which is something we're not going to get for a long time. So it's going to be a while before we actually get to use those items. It's kind of annoying, actually. I really wish it was easier to get to the Fire Projecting Mongols. Because they could have been a fun early game unit. Because by the time you get to this, like, they're just not very good anymore. Anyway, that's them. And then, in order to get the Matchlock Samurai, which would probably be the gun unit that we would use, although we could also use the Naginata, or sorry, not the Naginata, the Warrior Monk, Matchlock Warrior Monk, whatever the hell it's called, unit. Anyway, let's have another look in this this tree here. So we go to the Powder Maker, and we get, just the Fire Projecting Mongols. Then we go to the Gunsmith, we get the Much like samurai, of which we don't have a specific variety. Although the Hattori do, but the Hattori have a specific unit for everything. And we also get the Hojo hand mortars. That's another unit that I will probably use, but probably are not very good. They have a ridiculous range, though. They're a cool unit, they're just probably not very good. And then we go to the arsenal, which will bring us to the fire rockets. And that seems to be it. I don't remember how you get the guns. I think the guns you can only get through Christianity, through the Namban quarter or Namban trade port or something. I'll have a look at that in a minute as well. Anyway, match luck samurai. I don't think we need Christianity or anything for that. So yeah, we could use them. Not entirely sure how you get the warrior monk variety. Probably in this building somewhere. The famous temple. Really doubt we'll ever get this far anyway. I don't even see them yet, so maybe not. I don't know how you get those. I know there's a unit like that anyway. But yeah, I think the Siege Engineer's Workshop is definitely the most important building for us to get. And we do get one fire projecting monk, you know, when we get to strategy of attack, so at least we get to use one of them for a while. The problem is that then we only have one unit, and he's going to reduce our movement by a fuck ton for only one unit, and it's like, well, is it worth the payoff? Anyway, let me have a look at this building tree then. So we get the harbor, trading port, Namban trade port. I don't think this gives me it. Nope, it doesn't. But the Namban quarter, right, there you go. So yeah, actually, we do get the special variety. We get the Hojo cannons rather than the regular European cannons. Which is cool. But to go Christian just for the Hojo cannons, I don't think so. So probably not. But don't know yet. Anyway, for now, let's continue on. So we wanted to get a sword school. We can't make a sword school yet, so let's forget about that. We can make some roads. I think that's probably a good idea. This unit in here can reach the army, but it doesn't look like it's going to be able to reach the front lines. I think I do want to start sieging them. Okay, so we can do that with just this army. Alright. So let's just continue to siege there, and if they don't attack, we can... Oh, this unit actually seems to be in reinforcement range anyway, so that's great. We also encountered a Satomi, which I don't suppose we can trade with. No. How about the Imagawa? You changed your mind yet? No?
Welcome, right. Noble friend.
One thing to see is if anyone has any ladies so we can friend. Marry. I don't think we can actually
do you wish?
Marry anyone anyway, because we don't have anyone that can marry right now. Except for our general, I suppose. But he's not our son, so... Anyway, want to make him our commissioner for developments. Right, so that's all my money spent, unless I wanted to make a unit here, but nah, I'm not in a rush. I'm going to keep my Yari Samurai until we take this town, and then I'll get rid of him. Okay, looks like that turn is done too. Bushido next turn. I might actually want to go for Strategy of Attack first, just so we can get that Fire Projecting Mangano. And then we'll go for Todofuken afterwards. That seems fine to me. I'm actually looking forward to using that Fire Projecting Mangano. Alright, so the Takeda have already taken Narshinana as well. It's good for them. Alright, mastered that. We got another quest to capture the following province, Musashi, and we're working on that, so that's great. They will have to surrender before winter attrition hits, so that works out good for us. Get the shooting already. He's probably not going to be in range because last time he moved a little bit with the general. Great clan to start. I'm going to go ahead and guess the Tokugawa. Wow, what a surprise. Okay, so I want to make another unit now. Which leaves us enough money to either improve... Actually, we can make the sword school. I think I want to do that. And, yep, we are recruiting a unit, so that's great stuff. Alright, so I'm thinking they probably will still not come out and attack me. They'll do so when they absolutely have to. So next turn, or at the end of next turn, which means we'll have to suffer attrition after the battle. But at that point, it doesn't matter anymore. Unless they attack me now. Could happen. Because they do see I'm bringing over another unit. Yeah, there you go. And they're like, well, we don't want him to have another unit joining in, so let's attack him now, and it'll give us our best shot. Alright, so two Yari Ashigaru, one Boy Ashigaru, one Samurai Retainer unit, and a General. Should be fairly simple. We're just going to sit on whatever hill was closest. Which is Well, I suppose we can go take that hill. There's a little bit of little rockish area there as well, which will cover our right flank. It's just going to be a simple stand and shoot people and stay in Yari wall. It's not really anything to it. We have archer advantage because we have one unit with one chevron of experience, as opposed to there's one unit without the chevron of experience. So, and we have, of course, hill advantage. But depending on how far we sit back on the hill, he might have a forest, so I'll probably set up like around here, so at least he doesn't have the forest and we'll still have a hill advantage anyway. I really can't be bothered listening to this guy. Okay, so yeah, there's that little hillish or a rockish area. So we're gonna sit like right here-ish. So let's just plant the entire army right here. That'll do. Set up properly in a minute. Just gonna get my men over there. I could actually leave this guy here as a flanking unit. Alright. So, since he is the strongest unit, I want him in the middle. Oh, that's gonna be a nuisance again. Alright, whatever. Also, he's coming from there, so let's set up a little bit more. Let's see, where is the... Okay, that's where the rock area starts. So I'm just gonna set up more forward. Actually, you know what? I'll just leave him here as well. Let's plant him over here. We have this unit over here to sort of flank with anyway. Archer unit right behind. And generals can go for a little bit. Alright. Sounds good to me. This unit should be hidden here as well. Alright, now it's fine, so let's just do it. Actually, yeah, that was fine. Because I don't want to be sitting... It's not perfect the way it is. Oh, crap. No, I don't want the archer in there. Okay, well, in that case, it works better. I was going to say, I don't want to sit too much this way, because then these units aren't going to be hidden. And it's kind of useful to have all these hidden anyway. Alright, so apparently he's sending just this one unit up... Oh, no, there's another unit right in there. Get your ass into position. Okay, so everyone is hidden except for the general, so that works perfectly. What the hell? Move them up a little bit. Alright, so we're firing. Phone went off. Just gonna put these men into...
Our hidden units have been discovered, my lord!
Yari wall. Alright. Let's get normal speed going. There's no reason to get myself murdered. Alright, so he does have some of his units behind, so I don't really want to just charge all in there. Just get these guys to close the gap. I'll start charging his bow, I should gather. If these guys want to get engaged, that's fine. This is just a throwaway unit anyway. Okay, let's get them out of Yari. Well, let's charge them into the general unit. Oh yeah, there's some Samurai Retainers as well, though. Should be a fairly decent charge. Oh yeah, kill like 10, 15, 20 men in that charge. Not bad. Let's get this unit over there, actually. And our generals can go around too. Alright, their general already routed too. So this is already over. These men are routed. Some routiners will hang in there for a little bit. I'm actually going to chase off some of these routed units of one of the general unit. Don't need both of them engaged. Just need to make sure that they don't come back and start murdering my guys. That is a Yari Ishigata unit. Get this unit charged in the rear here. There we go, broke them. That should probably break them. There we go. Alright, that was fun. And the rest is all broken completely.
My lord,
or shattered.
A victory will soon be yours.
Really? Soon? How soon? Let's go. Let's stick to this unit for a little bit longer. What are they chasing? It must be chasing a particular man that's like. No, they're not. They were just being silly. Killed them anyway. Okay, well, that was really easy. How many men did you kill this time? 19. Well, look at that. It's an improvement over the 4 you killed last time. Did get a chevron, so I guess they killed most of that unit that we auto-resolved afterwards. Okay, so, yeah, that was like nearly a full unit I tried to get away, and he's now completely gone. There we go. Alright. decisive victory. I would say so. We may have completely... Actually, no, I don't think his general fell, so he probably did survive. But either way, it doesn't matter, because it wasn't winter just yet, since they didn't wait the turn. So we're not going to have to suffer for any attrition. So Musashi is ours, our first town. Gives us a total of 3 towns for all of you who are very terrible at maths. Alright, so we lost 95 men. Got some little experience on everyone. Sadly, the Yari Samurai did very well, so he got some experience. Oh, hello. Satomi apparently won a piece of that town as well. Well, I'm not having it, Satomi. I'm not having any of it. That's a fairly weak army. That's what to know, really. I'm going to be... actually, no, I'm not going to do that. Let's just attack. Alright. This guy comes in the reinforcements as well. Actually, may as well put him in there. He might get some experience too. Probably not, but you never know. Alright, let's be sure to occupy that. So we got Inspired Endeavors, which gives us extra money. And I like money. Let's get that repaired. Alright, so Musashi is actually a fairly good province for money. I believe they have fertile soil. No, average. But it's still alright for money. So I will make this into somewhat of a money-making province. I'll make roads first, though, because this place is pretty massive. And I will continue to make more Yari Ashigaru. And our armor is done in 2 turns. And after that, we will start making Yari Ashigaru with 2 armor, which is great. All right. Okay, Yatsu are dead. We encountered the Yamanuchi. They did say in the beginning of that thing that the Yamanuchi and the Ageyatsu teamed up together against me, but we're fine with the Yamanuchi. It's unacceptable. Well, that makes me very unhappy. Wow, why does no one want my trade? You changed your mind yet? No. Yeah, no one wants my trade. Right, so the question is, what are we doing now? Do we go on and attack more towns? It doesn't look like it, because Musashi is somewhat unhappy. It'll be happy next turn. But then, still, it's no chance for me to move out unless I want to exempt them from taxes right away. The question is, anyway, do I want to move east and take these 2 towns as well, or do I want to hang back and see what happens here? I actually want to see if I can get an alliance with them. I could.
There is always a welcome for you.
And it might be worth just forgetting about Tsuruga, getting an alliance with the Takeda, and getting an alliance with the Imagawa, which makes our western flank completely safe, which means we're not able to get those high level Metsukes right away, but it does give us a secure eastern or western flank, at least for the moment. There's a good chance the Oda have taken out the Tokugawa Mikawa. Well, actually, that's 100% what happened. So they own at least 2 provinces, and they might overpower the Imagawa, which in that case will be facing the Oda. We could already have a look see if the Takeda, they're not at war with the Oda, the Imagawa. I looked at the wrong thing. No, they're not war. Which means that since the Imagawa are already at war with the Oda and the Takeda are not, if they don't get pulled in, which I really don't see why they would, if the Oda were to take out the Imagawa, I'll be able to take see if I can get an alliance with the Oda, which might work out, and then they become my ally again for the how many of time in a row?
Tell me of the concerns.
Oh, they don't want alliance anymore. Well, that sucks. Let's see. We'll get it with the Takeda anyway, because they're in a reliable plan.
So, my friend, of what do you wish to talk?
Let's see if they want to pay me for it. They do. But how much? Probably very little. I'm going to say 150 tops. Let's try 200, but I really doubt they'll say yes. Oh, wow. I'm saying wow to 200 Koku, but this early in the game, that's a pretty decent amount. Let's go up a little bit bigger steps. I am actually somewhat surprised. They really want an alliance for some reason. Okay. They probably don't have that much money. 750? Oh man. 650? Oh, now you're just being kind of a dick, mate. Okay, so apparently 500 was the absolute max. Alright. It's a pretty good deal, though. I'll have it. And let's see what the Imagawa say now. It's still unacceptable.
So, my friend, of what do you wish to talk?
Alright. Anyone want to trade yet, now that I'm allied to the Imagawa? Or the Takeda, even? Oh, there you go.
So, my friend, of what do you wish to talk?
Don't know how that would have changed their minds. Oh, you're allied to the Takeda. Yeah, I like the Takeda. I'll trade with you. Okay. Sure. I hate this part of the game. I don't know why. Man, that 150 always gets me. Yep. Alright. Now, Yamanuchi, has that changed something for you? No. Imagawa, that changed something for you?
Let me listen.
Nothing. Alright. Maybe next turn. At least we got on the lines of the Takeda, which means that if the Imagawa were to attack me, the Takeda would join. Actually, no, they could choose who to join. But it's less likely that the Imagawa will attack me now anyway, since I would have liked a little triumvirate here, but we'll just deal with the Takeda for now. I probably should have taken the alliance with them before. But if anything, we wanted to have an alliance with the Takeda more than the Imagawa anyway, just so it leaves Suruga open for us. Right. Question it still remains. What do we do with our resources? I think it's time to build that coastal village, or make roads here. Izu is a good money-making province, so I do want to get this up soon. So I'll do that, and then maybe next year we'll make the harbor. I'm also going to get rid of this unit now. Save us 100-something odd every turn. I might get rid of the Boishigawa too, or I might make one more just so we have some kind of ranged force. I should have kept that unit to keep the town happy, but no, that's not worth it. I probably will make either one more. I'm not going to get rid of this guy anyway, because I do need another unit for happiness, so instead of getting rid of him, I'll make another one, and then we'll have two. We'll do that after that one is done, though. Alright, strategy of attack in two turns, which gives us one fire projecting Mangano, which is good, because I don't even know if I've ever used that unit in this game. Like, I have no idea. I may not have. Satomi, what is your plan? They are obviously a good target for me right now. Especially since they just moved away their army, but let's see who they are at war with. They are at war with the Satake. Okay, so they got two provinces as well, including one of the ones that we want. Although we won both of them, obviously, but let's get you in there. Let's get you over there. And, oh right, Katana Samurai are able to be made as well now, though. Let's make an archer, and then we'll make Katana Samurai afterwards. Okay, so I do want to make that. And, right. Like, I want to get this as well, but it's not, like, that important. I thought this said 600 before. Why is it 750 now? I think that may have changed. Yeah, this had 600 before as well, the rice paddies. Wait, no. I was going to say, maybe I got Todofuken or something, but no, I didn't. No, what? Oh, right, because of the plus 25%, yeah. Right, that makes sense. That sucks kind of, because I was thinking that we were making a decent amount of money, but it's only because of that. Well, I mean, it's not only because of that, but it is a little because of that. Anyway, I'm not going to attack just yet. I'm going to wait until they're at least one turn more away, and hopefully they don't take another town. I mean, it's not the end of the world, but are we making roads here as well? Yeah, we are, because fucking hell, we can't even get close to Shimazu in one turn. They only have trails, and they're not improving down either. Either way, I'm not attacking anyone right now. I need to take out their main army before I do anything like that. But we'll see what happens. Man, they are making like three units a turn right there. At least they didn't take a town. Alright, fire projecting Mangonels at your service. Definitely not going for that. Let's go for Todofuken. I might actually just go for equal fields right away, but. Okay. And armor. It's done. Wasn't it done last turn? Oh, no, it wasn't. No. Alright, so. Now we're gonna make Katana Samurai. Sweet. You're gonna go up there. And now this entire army can actually reach Shimosa in one turn because we made the roads. Good. Let's get you over there. Okay, so you can see this unit cannot move for the life of it. It's gonna take freaking... Look how little it moves on the second turn. I realize it's going through a forest, but still, that's insane. Let's look at its stats, by the way. Alright, so 450 range, 35 reload skill, 25 accuracy, 10 ammunition. Upkeep cost is surprisingly low, actually. It's not bad, and I believe... I don't know how many... Oh, operational guns, 4. It actually sounds like a reasonable unit. Oh, the accuracy is 25, so it's not very likely to hit, but... Right, the question is, do I attack the Satomi? We don't know where their army is. It's bound to be here somewhere. There's a good chance it's already in Itachi. Actually, yeah, what do we spend money on right now? The mine is not a terrible idea. Let's get that going. Neither is the harbor. Gonna make a market here, so I'm not gonna use that. This place does have average soil, so farm actually probably the best idea. And we already have one unit queued up in Katana Samurai. Right, do we attack? We can attack with everything except for this unit. We could take Shimosa in one fell swoop. Or we could attack this army, but there's a good chance it'll run. Also, Musashi is minus, or plus 3, plus 4, so we could technically only move out 4 units this turn. It would be 8 units, so it is in range of exempting taxes as well. Plus, this unit could sit in there next turn. They're upgrading the farm. Let's wait 2 turns before I take it. Just gotta hope that they don't take any more provinces. But I suppose if they do, it's not the end of the world. Especially since it is more provinces that I want to take anyway. But I also don't want to get spread too thin right now. Okay, they are in reinforcement range of Shimosa. They didn't make any more units though this time, so that's good. So if we were to attack it, they would come into reinforcement range. They still have another army which is about similar size, which is definitely doable with this what we have right now. Next turn it'll be winter, so I don't want to move next turn either. I suppose I could wait for these units to arrive as well. We'll wait at least 2 more turns, so that means the Katana is going to be like right here. No, it's going to get inside on the turn that we want to move, which means it won't be able to reach Shimosa unless they're making trails or roads here as well, but I doubt they will. Alright, at least Wave Chi is nearly done. I don't really like waiting too long. Alright, make trade port, it's important. Still have a unit queued up. How much does he cost anyway? 183. Not too bad. I'm just gonna make 2 units for now. 2 of those units gonna make a hell of a difference. Takeda are still moving along, just take Tukida. It's not bad. Same size as I am now. Okay, they just moved away, so now Shimosa is an even easier target, but again, that means they have a bigger army somewhere excellent as well.
Morale. These warriors are
right. Yeah, sorry. I don't know what the hell I was thinking about there. Shimazu are dead. I should see if I can get an alliance with them. They do take
there
it now.
Always right. A welcome for you.
And the question is, will I take it? I think I will.
Speak, and I will listen. If I can help, I will try to do so.
See how much money we can take out of them. Oh, only 50. Alright. How about 75? Just because I'm stingy. They'll do it as well. Alright. A trade on top of that? No. They really, really don't want my trade. It's like an alliance? Alright, but trade with the alliance? No, no way, mate.
I will listen.
Don't want any of that. How about now that we've actually got the alliance? No, still
it is good to...
Okay. Right. How far can you get? You can get there next turn. You can move further. Right, are you making roads? No, you are making the harbor now, though, so I'm gonna wait at least 1 more turn. I really wish I knew where their army was. Right, we have money. We can make markets now, so let's do so. Make one there. And I suppose I'll make one here as well, since we have the exact amount of money. Oh, no, actually, I wanna queue up another katana. Does this give us enough money for that? Just about. Which means we can't make the market, but hey, whatever. Katana is more important. That one unit will fuck up at least 4 Yadashigaru on its own. Oh, this is so tempting. It is so tempting. We know they have at least like, I don't know, what, like 15 units or something, which we can deal with. I'm not worried about that. And I suppose if I, like, taking them during winter might actually be a good idea, since it'll mean that they suffer through attrition if they can't reach me. I have a good idea that they must be fighting here. Maybe they don't even have that full stack anymore. They've probably been depleted heavily. Yeah, this is the opportune time to attack. Let's do it. I'm not gonna ask my allies. I don't want them to break their lines. Oh, frick. Their army's right there. Okay, I could do a night attack so this unit doesn't join in, but I actually wanted to join in. Okay. Oh, and there's their other army. I should have probably just declared war on them, and then I would have seen them on the way. Okay, they have some Yari Samurai in there. Now, the thing is, I'm not worried about them attacking Shimosa, but I am worried if they attack Musashi, I might be dead. It's more likely that they will attack Shimosa, because it was their province. But if they don't, then we're going to lose Musashi, we're going to lose this unit as well, and then I have to go on the offense against them. But that's just something we'll have to wait and see what happens there. There's not much we can do about it. Anyway, we can try to DM a or the Satake, if they want to, which they do.
And I will give you good attention.
They will pay me at least 50. Good. I love 50 Koku. But how much are you willing to pay me? Probably, again, 150. Nope, they are willing to pay me more than that. 150 is like a magical number. Like, early on in the game, for whatever reason, all the things are 150 or 350. So, like, when you're trying to get or when you're trying to sell military access, it's usually 350 in the early game for God knows what reason. In this case, it's 400. Just because it's got to prove me wrong, obviously. I wonder if they would take an alliance. No, they really don't want an alliance. I don't even want an alliance with them. I'm just wondering. Okay. I also wonder if they would take peace. No. I'd have to actually beat one of their armies first. Okay, so I guess the moment of truth. Do they attack me or do they... Well, do they attack Shimosa or do they attack Musashi? Musashi is unhappy, by the way, but that's fine. We'll deal with that. Let's see what they decide. They may even have a few units coming from their other town as well, to my southwest. I really hope they attack Shimosa. See, there's a few units. Sorry, they're meeting up first, which means they're going to suffer a turn of attrition, which is great. Right. Construction complete. And the Otomo are dead. Alright, so this entire island's already rid of all their major clans. Sadly, oh, actually, he might be able to get inside the town. That'd be really good. Even if he stands right outside, it's not terrible. I'd rather have a Yari Ashigaru standing outside, but hey, what are you gonna do? You're gonna go into Musashi. Although this, it could mean that they want to attack this unit instead, but hey, that's fine. Alright, so they do have a total of 8, 14, 16 units against my 4, 8, 10, plus, well, that one, so, oh, and him, so, say 11, 12 or so. They have somewhat superior, well, they don't. It depends on how many Yaris, Yari Samurai they have. I can see at least 3, so there might be 2 or 3 more in here as well. So there's probably a few. This place is -2, which technically means that if I were to make a unit here, I would be happy next turn. Making a unit there means I would want to make a bow unit, because otherwise I miss out on armor. I mean, I still do, but... Or I could just exempt it for one turn, and that would be fine too. I miss out on 500 bucks, and I don't really want an archer, so yeah, alright. We have money, so let's make a market here. And I think I'll upgrade that too, since there's not much else I'm going to do. I still want to get this, but it's not that high priority. As long as I don't have any Metzgades, it's not going to make a massive deal in, when it comes to income anyway. Let's see if anyone has changed their minds yet. Imagawa. Oh my god, I thought I accidentally cancelled my alliance there. That would have been annoying. Because for some reason, Like, a lot of things, you have to click it and then, like, confirm it with cancelling alliance, and there's a few more as well, like, in the hope of mutual profit. I think when you're trading with someone, you can break trade, or break your agreement for military access, and it's, like, instant for whatever reason. I have no idea why it does that. Anyway, I have no idea what I'm checking right now. This is end of turn. Just wasting time, putting off my imminent doom. No. That's not true. We're gonna easily take care of this army. Well, not easily, but we're gonna take care of this army. There's a good chance he's gonna attack me now. I would assume so. Oh, they're kind of dicks, aren't they? Takeda has lost the province, and the Imagawa seem to be going strong against the Oda, which is somewhat surprising. Alright, so there's a raid. And Crown adopts Christianity Shoni, and we made our second Katana Samurai. Alright, I'm gonna end it there. So that's the first episode of the Hojo campaign. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and I shall see you next time. Have a good one. Bye-bye.